Mark Sommer talks about an interesting era in Cleveland baseball. Rocky Colavito, Cleveland's iconic slugger. And Rocky will be here. That'll be on July 5th. It's a Friday night at 7:30, and it's at the State Theater. And you can go to playhousesquare.com for more information, and .org, rather, playhousesquare.org, and get tickets for that. It is leading into the All-Star Week, which is leading into a lot of people coming into town.
Which is a good thing.
It is a good thing. Mark, an interesting thing about Colavito is his relationship with Herb Score, who I think we all agree, had he not gotten hit by the line drive by Gil McDougal, probably would be a Hall of Famer. I know it's too early. He only had two and a half seasons of being able to pitch until he tried to pitch after, but set his arm, he had a sore arm as a result. Tell us about those two who got traded on two consecutive days in spring training in 1960.
They were very close, as you say. They roomed together for Plunkett's 7 seasons. I want to point out something that you said that Rocky would disagree with. Herb Score believed this as well, that it wasn't that an infamous line drive off the bat of Gil McDougal and the Yankees that hit Herb Score in the eye that really derailed Herb Score's career. What Rocky would say, and again, what he said Herb Score said is in addition, is that Herb Score recovered from that. He was back on the mound the next year. He was throwing well, and he hurt his arm on a pitching mound in Washington, D.C. And then he re-injured that arm on the same mound on a subsequent appearance. That, more than anything, is what Rocky would say for and really ultimately kind of ended Herb Score's career as a fireballing pitcher.
You know, you also said something to me that I found surprising. I told you that while I really liked Rocky Colavito, my favorite of that era was Roger Maris, who did pretty well once he got to New York. But you told me they were roommates too, right?
They did. They roomed together in the 57 season. At the time, they were both vying for the starting right field job on the Indians, even though Rocky had a chance to win the starting position the year before, but they were still in competition. But they hit it off right from the bat. I don't think people know that as well about Rocky. They know about Rocky and Herb Score being close. The two of them, you know, really shared a kind of blue-collar work ethic. They were devoted family men, consummate team players. And they really, you know, I would say commanded the respect and admiration of teammates and opposing players. They were also very proud. They were confident. They could be stubborn. They had short fuses. And they were both known to carry a grudge. They were really two peas from the same pod in many ways.
Hey, Mark, what did you learn? Anytime you do a project like this, you learn something that kind of surprises you. What did you learn about Rocky that really kind of surprised you?
Well, I learned that he is incredibly modest. It was very difficult for him to tell me stories sometimes without, he would always have to say, I say this in modesty. It was like a disclaimer before he thought he could go on and talk about this. I wasn't aware of his penchant for signing autographs after games the way he did. Talked to many fans who were the beneficiaries of those autographs and what it meant to them. And that came simply from him as a boy wanting to get autographs of ball players. And Rudy York, who was at the star with the Detroit Tigers, brushed him off once, and he thought to himself, if I'm ever a star, if I ever get to play in the major leagues, I'll never treat the kid that way. And, he lived that way. So that was something else that I thought was pretty cool about Rocky as a ball player. I didn't know the Italian-American connection, how strong that was, so I started talking to Italian-Americans in Northeast Ohio when working on the book. That was something else. But I didn't really know, couldn't maybe fully appreciate their experience and why he mattered.
All right, Mark, we appreciate you taking the time to talk to us. We're looking forward to the book, Cleveland's Iconic Slugger. That would be Rocky Colavito. We had a poll on our an email earlier, and And we had a lot of people hoping that the Indians would put up a statue in center field for Rocky Colavito. I'm not sure that'll happen, but a lot of people have fond memories of the Rock and what he did with the Cleveland Indians. But, Mark, best of luck. It's July 5th, 7:30 at the State Theater, downtown Cleveland, and tickets available at playhousesquare.org. And best of luck, and thank you for joining us tonight.
Thanks for giving me the chance. I really enjoyed it.
Terrific. Mark Sommer, who has written that book,